So you own an energy system that operates on batteries, and you would like to understand a bit more about what's happening during discharging and charging. What does it mean, all those charging stages, the bulk, absorption, float, equalization? What kind of voltages should you see? When is your battery full? When do you need to equalize? And possibly, what could you do to improve the performance of your system, extend the lifetime of your batteries? Well, in this video, I'll explain to you what's happening during the different charging and discharging stages of your battery. And by the end of this video, you'll understand what is supposed to happen and what to look out for in your system. I'm Jesse. I'm a renewable energy engineer. I've worked in the industry for several years, and I've run companies in the design and installation of off-grid battery-based solar energy systems. And I've recently held the position of energy officer for the United Nations. I founded the company Solar Solution, through which I share my knowledge and expertise through online videos, articles, and through personal support on my website. In the first topic, we'll describe in a few sentences how a battery actually works. In the second topic, we'll run through a couple of the values that we normally use to describe electricity. In the third one, we'll look a little bit more into depth into the charging algorithm, different steps, the voltages, the battery charge percentages, etc. And the number four is the bonus topic, because I'm getting a lot of questions about equalization. I think it's good that I explain you a few basic principles about it. By the way, to keep the size and the content of this video manageable, we'll only look at the lead acid based battery. So this includes the flooded lead acid batteries and the valve regulated lead acid batteries, including the AGMs and gel batteries. Okay, let's get started. The first topic, what is actually happening in a battery? A battery takes energy in the form of electricity and stores it into chemical energy. Now, what I would like you to remember about this is that as you take the electrical energy and turn it into chemical energy, the conversion ratio is not 100%, it's always a little bit less. And if you discharge, so if you take the chemical energy and turn it into electrical energy, also this process is not 100% efficient. So I'm mentioning this to you because it makes it easy to understand why charging and discharging of batteries is just not 100% efficient. It is also one of the reasons why batteries just don't last forever. Okay, that's enough about batteries. Let's look at the units that we normally use to describe electricity, and I'll mention three. The voltage, the amperage, and the power. Now, when I was a kid, I was fooling around with electricity, and I couldn't quite understand it. So what my dad did, he explained it to me by using the example of water in a garden hose. Now imagine that you're going to wash your car, you got a garden hose in your hand, you close the end off, and you try to pinch the hose and you feel a certain pressure. Now this pressure is similar to the pressure of electricity, and in electricity we describe it as the voltage. Now if you would open the nozzle completely and you let the maximum amount of water flowing out, the amount of water flowing out is similar to the amount of electricity, which is described as amperage. Now you want to spray some dirt over your car, so you squeeze the nozzle a little bit, you get this powerful jet of water. Now this powerful jet is similar to the power of electricity. And therefore, maybe it's easy for you to understand that power is the result of pressure and flow. It is the result of voltage and amperage. Okay, so now that you're fully up to date with those two topics, we can look at the charging stages, being bulk, absorption, and float. So the first stage is bulk, in which the battery is typically less than 80% charged. Now in this stage, we generally allow as much power to flow into the battery as possible, as long as we meet two different conditions. The first one is that the amount of electricity flowing into the battery, being the amperage, should typically not exceed 20% of the total amp hour rating of the battery. So the second one is that as we push this energy into the battery, we don't want the pressure of the battery, so the voltage of the battery, to go beyond a certain level. And this level is described as the absorption voltage, and it's set in your charger devices. So that brings us to the absorption stage. If, as a result from the charging in the bulk stage, the pressure in the battery has reached the absorption voltage, the absorption pressure, your charging device will now switch its behavior. What it will start to do is it will start to maintain this pressure, this voltage in the battery. It can reach the end of absorption either when a certain time frame has been set, for example, 2 or 3 hours maximum absorption time, or secondly, it can end the absorption when the amount of power that you need to push into your battery, the amount of amps required in order to maintain the absorption voltage, falls below a certain preset value. Now at this point, you've reached the float stage, in which your battery is as fully charged as it can possibly be, and the voltage will be lowered to a more moderate voltage setting, which is the float voltage. Now, I'm intentionally saying that the battery is as full as it can possibly be, because it doesn't mean that your battery now has the capacity that it had when it was new. It just means that you have charged it as full as it can under the current conditions. For the specific float voltage for your battery, I'm going to say the same as for the absorption voltage. Download specification sheet, look in it, because it really depends which battery you have. But typically it is between 13 to 14 volts. Now, if you forget everything else in this movie apart from this one, I'll be very happy. You would preferably want to reach float stage every day. Less ideal would be every 4 to 5 days. Less than that, and you would probably be affecting the lifetime of your battery. Now, one last thing, and it's a tip specifically for boat and RV owners. What you normally see is that you've got your panels mounted somewhere on your deck or on your roof, and your batteries are down in the bilge, your lockers, or somewhere under your RV. And you've got your charge controller mounted in a convenient spot for you so that you can read out the charging stage or whatever's going in or out of your battery. But what you should be aware of is that, you know, where your batteries are stored, the temperature can fluctuate significantly due to the sun or the engine or whatever reasons. But as the temperature from the battery changes, you should also adjust the voltage in order to squeeze out the maximum lifetime of the battery. Now, the good thing is that your charge controller can do this automatically. It measures the temperature and then adjusts the voltage accordingly. The tricky thing is that if you've got your charge controller and your batteries mounted in separate locations, your batteries can become boiling hot, but your charge controller thinks, I'm fine, I don't have to adjust the voltage. So how do you fix or improve this? Either way, you can install your charge controller in the same temperature zone as your battery, or if your charge controller allows for it, you can connect either way a hardwired or a wireless temperature sensing device between your charge controller and the batteries itself. Okay, so the last topic, equalization. So as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, the charging and discharging of batteries is never 100% perfect. And on top of that, you know, sometimes you can just not manage to get your batteries into float regularly. Now, there is a quick and dirty solution for this, which is called equalization. During equalization, the battery voltage will be raised to a very high level for a certain amount of hours. So what happens during equalization is that bubbles are formed on those two plates that I mentioned earlier on in the video. And those bubbles will blow off any kind of hard sulfur particles that might have formed on the plates itself. And those particles will fall down in the battery. So what those bubbles will also do is that they'll mix up the electrolyte in your battery and they'll distribute it evenly throughout. Now you can imagine that these bubbles will not only blow off the sulfur particles from your plates, but they might also blow off some of the actual lead on your plates, which will just fall off, go to the bottom of your battery, can never be recovered, or actually then reduce the overall capacity and lifetime of your battery. Now, as I said, the bubbles normally mix up the liquid, the electrolyte in your battery, but if your liquid is absorbed in a glass mat, an AGM or in a gel battery, then this doesn't work really well. So typically AGM and gel batteries do not require and are not allowed to be equalized. Okay, so I hope this gives you a basic understanding of what's happening during the different charging stages in your battery. If there is something else that you would like me to present videos or articles about, let me know in the comments below and I'll use it as inspiration to produce more content. And as always, you know, if you like this video, I'd really appreciate if you can give me a thumbs up. It kind of keeps me motivated. And I'll see you in the next video.